Hey, Norman. Guys, before we get the video kicked off, I want to remind you about the 2.4 hours of Les Mulets. If you guys haven't got your tickets yet, it is $15 a day of or $10 in advance. Also, if you spend over, I believe it's 50 bucks with Summit, you get a free ticket to that. So check that out as well. Definitely pumped to have Cooper as my teammate. I also wanted to thank you guys for your support because you guys are truly changing the trajectory of Faster Proms, making a difference in our lives. So thank you so very much for that. Please check out our merch at the Faster Proms store. Get hats, t-shirts, stickers, lanyards, and even some sweaters. Now, let's get on the video. Guys, thanks for coming back to Faster Proms YouTube channel. This is my son, Christian. He is 14 years old and he's been driving go-karts for a long time. But today you got something a little bit different.
Oh, so yeah.
Both these cars have been pretty cheap to put together, and they've been a tremendous amount of fun, and you've learned a lot on them.
Mm-hmm.
We're over to a buddy's place up in North Georgia, and he's got a go-kart track right here. It's been a tremendous amount of fun and an awesome blessing. We're going to try this out. So Garrett and I have done this a while back. It turned out really, really cool. We had seen Vaughn and Chelsea do this, and hey, this is the next generation here. I know I'm about as old as Vaughn. Pretty soon, both my sons will be able to do this, and I think this is going to be a hell of a lot of fun. This car only makes like 215 wheel horsepower. Pretty basic.
It's comfortable.
Yeah.
A lot more than BMW.
We've put her off the track a few times here. And this right here, this thing makes about 260 something horsepower and about 3,000 pounds. Pretty decently set up car. I think we can be able to make this happen. Let's give it a try. And also, guys, one of my favorite things in the world to do, this is Cletus's cart. I've been taking care of this thing off and on for a few years. We were messing around with it a little bit late last night, and turns out we had some fuel that was super, super old.
Replaced the
fuel.
Months.
No, I think it's longer than that. I think it's probably like 9 months old. But we got some new fuel in it, and this thing rips. So we'll take you guys for a little ride in this a little bit later here. But it is just violent. This is like driving a 2,800 to maybe 3,000 pound car with like 750 wheel horsepower. It is a monster car, and it just feels like a super fast car. So everything after this feels slow. So we don't have all our jets here, and it's about probably 50 degrees right now. We had to kind of do some modding. So our redneck tuning here is we covered up a lot of the intake right there, and hopefully that'll be enough to be able to choke it down a little bit and run pretty well. All right, let's do this.
All right, guys, I forgot to mention that this is the same guy that taught me how to do 360. We'll show you a clip of that right here.
Dude, that was so sick.
There, just like you are, three rotations where you came, flip it that way, and then go the other direction. So we reverse the rotation.
Not very good at donuts this way, though.
Try it, you can do it.
Super proud of my son. I know he could do this. I knew he had it in him, and he was really executing it well. However, we think we can do just a little bit better, so we're gonna give it one more go, and hopefully we can totally knock this out of the park. So check it out.
All I like it, man. You got good control. Got a lot more power, so it kind of slides faster, but very cool.
Well, good job, buddy.
That's awesome.
Definitely, man. I tried to get really nice and close to you, but
you got real close.
We'll see what that looks like. I felt awesome. Very good control, man. 14 years old, killing it, brother. I should say son. But these cars manageable with this power level right here. It's just like, it's so easy, and this is like, it's such a privilege.
Definitely a proud father-son moment. Hope you guys can be able to experience that one time. Definitely very, very cool.
Man, you got close at one point. I was like, woo!
All right, let's go for a minute ride on the shift cart here. It's super hard to convey how fast this darn thing is, but it is just wicked fast, and traction is definitely lacking. Got some old tires. It's just been a while since this thing's been really well taken care of, but I totally forgot how much I absolutely freaking love this thing. In this kind of weather, the tuning was a little bit off, but my son drove it pretty darn good, especially for being a little bit rusty, having poor tires, and not having a good tune-up. Can't wait to get back and spend more time in these things. This is truly the absolute pinnacle of motorsports of what I've experienced. Once you've driven a shifter car, there's truly nothing like it. It really does make everything else feel slow, and so hard to ever experience those type of G's that you will have in such a small, inexpensive, low center of gravity with just such tremendous traction. It is so hard on your body, and I've been sore for a couple days afterward. All right, guys, that was absolutely awesome. I'm so proud of my son. He really did a great job as he continues to learn at such a young age. Both of my boys are so, so advanced in driving. I can't wait to keep pushing them further. But right now, we've got some tech tips that we'd kind of like to share with you guys. If you guys have been watching for a while, you know that we work on a whole lot of CTSVs and ZL1s and stuff like that. And all that late model supercharged stuff has its little idiosyncrasies, little things that it kind of wants or needs in order to make best power. So here, we're going to share that with you right here. All right, a little earlier, we were tackling a CTSV2 that came in for pretty much a bolt-on package. We can do this in about a day, and it's pretty awesome to see that we can basically, within a day, crank out something that's making 100, 120 wheel overstock. It already has intake and headers, so it's got intake and exhaust. We're putting a pulley on, flex fuel. We change the plugs out. It has some cooling modifications, injectors.
It's only going to be 100 overstock?
It should still be about 100. I mean, between pulley and flex fuel, that's basically 100 right there.
Yeah, but he's already got headers.
No, that's true, but it doesn't have a tune for all that stuff, though, too. So
it's got all the low-hanging fruit, as you would say.
I like it. Indeed. Indeed. So this is 120,000 mile CTSV, and honestly, so Laz, we've been flowing injectors left and right, trying to make sure that things, and we found a whole lot of them, that basically we've seen a rash of injectors going bad and or having issues. So we've checked a bunch of different things, and we took these out, and we're gonna flow them and see how, you know, how bad they are. Even though we're replacing them, I just kind of wanted to find out what they're doing, you know, but
see what percentage twin cylinders you have there.
Yeah, we had a car the other day that had two cylinders that were 20% down. So that was my hunch, but I didn't know.
So when you're tuning towards the low cylinders to make everything safe.
Yeah, so it would show lean, or a particular bank would be leaner, and I'm trying to throw more fuel at it and the power is down. If everything flows evenly and each cylinder is getting the proportion amount of fuel, it's gonna make more power.
You ought to do that.
The Miata did do that.
Your own personal car.
Yep, my own personal car, for sure. This blower's seen some better days, but we got our injectors in there and all that, and we got our pulley on. So
an isolator I already had, so that was nice.
I know we've talked about this many times in the past here, but on something that we're really turning up the power, it doesn't matter what it is. We want to see a little bit colder plugged in stock. Now, this is a 7 heat range, but it's an Iridium, and this one right here, these tend to spark knock more than an NGK BR70F. So we change the plugs to a colder, which again, doesn't protrude as far out, sunk down into the plug deeper.
and it is less likely to spark, and that holds less heat, because this thing's going to generate a lot of heat. And
speaking of heat, we're doing our thermal plates to this?
No, we're actually not.
Not?
It didn't fit in the budget. Did not fit in the budget, so.
But we are doing the block-off plates to direct the airflow.
Yep, absolutely. So these panels right in here, we put those in and really optimize everything such that we're directing airflow, or we're directing heat away from the air filter right here, because the radiator puts a lot of heat right in there. We're blocking that off. We're gonna block it off on the top side right there. And on this factory heat exchanger, we have this piece that inserts right in there that helps direct airflow. Instead of going around the heat exchanger through the bottom, it goes and directs it up to the bottom. So that's exactly one of those items that we would have, as we say, for that low-hanging fruit. Really makes this package a heck of a lot more clean and optimized. So Laz, have you looked at the thermometer when we're around the dyno the last couple days?
No, I don't want to.
102 the other day, a couple days in a row. It was just miserable hot here. And this gentleman right here on a car that already generates a ton of heat believes that his factory intercooler pump, which is very much just like a little Cobra one that they have, failed. And that is a perfect way to kill the engine. An uncontrollable amount of heat, it would be like you being out in the sun and not able to sweat. You just get too hot, overheated, and obviously it's a terrible thing. But this is just some of the rudimentary stuff of what we would do on any given day. Just kind of wanted to share it with you guys because there's neat little tricks and tips that we have that can help make a little bit more power here and there. Now, another really popular thing with the CTSVs and any of these late model GM forced induction cars is that over time, and also, this is pretty, that's really thin. That sounds like basically two soda cans thickness right there. Not three, two.
Well, you talk about the thickness, the boost pressures are actually higher than the coolant pressure inside the brick.
Yeah.
So I ended up concaving that.
Yeah. And I mean, furthermore, if we have an intercooler pump that's not working and we have air in that, we opened that up and there was nothing came out.
Oh, that's awesome.
So if there's just air in there, we don't have the pressure, it's that much weaker. And if the intercooler pump goes out, the heat has risen a whole bunch. It's going to be a lot easier for that thing to cave in. We really don't want that to happen, but Laz is going to tear this apart, reinforce this, put another piece of thicker aluminum in there, and make that thing stronger.
Hope you guys enjoyed that little talk nerdy section. Some of that stuff really helps not only on supercharged engines, but a lot of naturally aspirated stuff as well. If you guys are not yet subscribed, please hit that subscribe button. Also, check us out on Instagram and check out our Facebook as well. It's at Faster Proms on Instagram and Faster Proms on Facebook. Wanted to say thank you guys again for your support. And right about this time, I'm going to leave you with a quote. Now, this one is from Voltaire. It says, "Those that make you believe absurdities can make you commit atrocities." Definitely wanted to think about in these crazy times here. And the song I wanted to leave you with, I kind of forgot about this. I absolutely used to love this song. I ran across it the other day, and it is just an absolute gem. And that is Doesn't Remind Me by Audioslave. Hope you guys enjoy. God bless you. We'll see you next episode. All right, guys, that was absolutely awesome. I'm so proud of my son. He really did a great job as he continues to learn at such a young age. He's got so much driving time and skill way beyond stuff that I've ever done. He's got some great opportunities, and both of my boys are so advanced in driving. I can't wait to keep pushing them further. But right now we've got some tech tips that we'd kind of like to share with you guys. If you guys have been watching for a while, you know that we work on a whole lot of CTSVs and ZL1s and stuff like that. And all that late model supercharged stuff has its little idiosyncrasies, little things that it kind of wants or needs in order to make best power. So here, we're going to share that with you right here.